Hey, what's up? Welcome back. This is the next day from my last video where my truck got completely massacred, so I decided to do a rebuild. I'm armoring the hell out of the thing, so you can see in front of me. I made a lot of changes. One of the things I wanted to make a quick video is you can see how many blocks of armor this thing requires just for one side, and it was a bitch just putting the framework in, and I was not going to weld one block at a time, because it takes like 10 seconds per block, and you add it all up, I'd be here literally all day just welding these blocks. So what I did, oh, I died. Why was that? Oh, because I fell into the... I forgot to turn the welder off. Guess that'll happen. I got to respawn in my medical bay. By the way, I got the screens working now. The development version of the game broke the script, so the author came out with a quick fix for it. So now it's working. It's nice because I used the damage. It says no damage blocks found up there. If there are any systems on the ship that are damaged, it'll tell me. That is really cool because it allows me. I mean, this thing's so big, sometimes you don't know if a solar panel or a tire or something else has a problem. We'll grab my corpse. Yeah, I fell in front of the welder. I forgot to shut it off. What the hell? I had my jetpack on. Let's do that again. Jetpack is on. Why did I fall to my death? Maybe I turned off my thingy. The crater I made. I thought I saw my health blinking there. One of the things I don't like about this game is that it only marks your last corpse, so if you die more than once, and your bag falls into the dirt, which happens like, 80% of the time, and you lose everything. And I'm not gonna tell you how many times I lost everything on my corpse, and when I had like tons of uranium and stuff that I actually, looted from. Why is not really gonna pick this up? One of the things I also don't like is when you die, your character also drops one of the items that you carry. It's like what's in your hand drops, and then what's in your backpack drops. And the problem is now I can't find my welder. Let me sneak in from behind. Back in the cockpit. Yes. I wish it made some noise while the welder was on. There. Now I won't kill myself again. Well, it looks like my my welding tool is gone. Must have fell into the dirt. And could have been anywhere around where my backpack was. I probably wasn't really paying attention. I probably should have. Oh. Well, looks like I have to make another one. Better do that really quick. It's important to have my welder. My hand welder. Hopefully. Are you kidding me? I don't have enough cobalt. I basically stripped the station down to almost nothing. One thing it's another. Let's see. What can give me some cobalt real quick? I don't need a lot. I don't want to get rid of my metal grid. Thruster. I really don't. I think those are only used for the ion thrusters. Regular thrusters don't require those, the atmosphere ones. Which is nice, because those are kind of a bitch to make. Just a little bit of a bitch, not a big bitch. Disassemble. Inventory. Okay, I grabbed them in my inventory. Type in assembler. Oh, you know what? It's not looking for the title. It's looking for the item inside. What the hell? Yeah, I'm probably going to need some steel plate to finish this. It's assembler 3. I want to assemble assembler 4. Why is it lagging out all of a sudden? I'm like 1 frame per second. Really bad. It might just because I'm running for ops. It's almost unplayable. Alright, please. It's agonizingly slow. There we go. I know what I did. I made the wrong thing. Man, I've been awake for a while. Okay, assembler. Grind it up. Try making the right thing this time. Where's the welder? There it is, hiding at the bottom. What the hell is missing? I still need more cobalt. This is a real pain. Okay, I'm gonna just pause the video until I'm back in the craft. It's boring. Okay, we're back. And it was definitely Fraps recording. It was causing the frame rate issues. As soon as I shut off Fraps, it was back up. Anyway, just a quick, this ship used to be a miner that came with the base. I wrecked a little bit. So some of the engines and stuff were gone, and basically what I did is I repurposed this craft because it was already pretty solid. I took all the drill bits off the front and I put a welder in. I never really used the welder before on crafts, and it works really well. It certainly beats doing it by hand. So I put a welder up front, a camera so I get perspective because I can't actually see it from the cockpit. it's too high. And then on the back, I put a grinder, which is a little strange to use because all the controls are backwards, and I've almost flipped this thing a couple times trying to use it. But the grinder is so that I could. I'm basically out of materials. So I've been, as you can see, I've been grinding up some of these heavy armor to get the grid components and the steel plate that I need in order to armor my big ass Humvee over here. So I want to show you how cool this is. Let's go ahead and put the welder back on and remember this time not to jump out until I shut it off. Kick on the camera for the front. See, this is the camera right next to the welder up front, so it gives me a bird's eye view. So we'll just start at the top and show you how quick this is in comparison to doing it by hand. So try to do it so that I'm level. You don't have to actually touch it, you just have to get close. See how many of it's doing it all at once. You can't beat that. These are heavy armor blocks, so like I said, each one takes like 10 seconds to do it by hand, even with my enhanced welder. For some reason, the ship, it tends to sink very slowly. It's just like the balance of the engines or what. All my other ships, you know, look perfectly in midair. This one, which is a bad thing, because it's basically a hands off right now. They can take a drink and basically wait for this to finish. Look how big this thing is, man. It's a big ass ship. Well, now it's floating upward. Since I changed the view, it's kind of weird. Yeah. Oh, it's actually doing some of the roof blocks. I'm not even anywhere near that. It's got quite a range. I think it's like a 3x3x3 cube. Yeah, this totally beats doing one block at a time and having to carry all that inventory, because the grids are pretty heavy, where they require a lot of volume. And then you have tons of steel plate. My inventory should run it out soon, because I did the whole other side of the ship. It uses a lot of materials. Yeah, I'm getting down there. What's neat is I just transferred that cargo from the cockpit. I think I have the cockpit set up with a large conveyor so that I can pass large items just right from the cockpit into the storage. That was not a great deal. I think there's some grid at the base. Wow, look at that. That's cool. I intentionally did leave little holes here and there because I need to access cargo and stuff. And sometimes I just want to be able to reach in from the side instead of having to get into the cockpit or do a remote. This thing's going to be done pretty soon. Oh, there goes the goes the frame rate again. I'm gonna have to stock traps. Probably a good thing, because really I'm just gonna put some more materials in here and then finish the armor. And then it's time to go, because I spent literally all day doing this, and I really want to get out there and do some adventuring. I think this time it's gonna be much more badass. A lot more, with all this armor, and a lot more weapons. I'll give you another quick tour of my changes that I made since yesterday. Since yesterday's major failure, I made an agglomerator and basically got my ass kicked by one bad guy. So, that shouldn't be the problem anymore. Okay, Fraps is acting up, so I'm going to go ahead and stop it and resupply, finish this thing up, and I'll start recording once I'm ready to roll.